now, preview time. When it comes to entertainment, you can't beat a good film. So let's take a look at what's coming your way.
What's up, discerning cinema goers? First of all, I want you to let your mind go blank and look into the center of the screen. Click on the link below. Anyway, my first film this week is I'm Thinking of Ending Things by the great master Charlie Kaufman.
Hello? We're here.
Oh, hi. Oh, it's all wet.
Here they come.
Oh, Jeff has told us so much about you.
He's told me so much about both of you, too.
And you came anyway.
Jake tells me you're studying quantum psychics.
Physics.
Really?
But there's just something profoundly wrong here.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I think you've ending.
I am so glad Jake has found someone.
Soon this will all be a distant memory.
Who's this?
It's me.
No, it was me.
Just last month, Charlie Kaufman released his epically bizarre new novel, Antkind, and now it seems as productive as Joyce Carol Oates. He has this rather brilliant new film, of which the foregoing clip gave you hardly a taste. Jessie Buckley is brilliant as a young woman who, through a weird mixture of boredom and an inability to think of anything else to do, has got involved in a dull and unsatisfying relationship with a boring but nice guy, played by Jesse Plemons, who has now invited her to meet his parents, which involves a long, cold, disagreeable drive out to their remote farm in the countryside. They are played, rather brilliantly, by Toni Collette and David Thewlis. It is at this moment that a still, small, anxious little voice in Buckley's head tells her that she doesn't really want to be with this man. She's thinking of ending things with him. And she's vouchsafed a vision or anti-epiphany, as if looking through a microscope or the wrong end of a telescope, of the arbitrary pointlessness of their supposed lives together as a couple, and the arbitrary pointlessness of all life. How many times in your life have you heard a movie or a drama or a novel described as dreamlike? It's the biggest cliche there is, and mostly it means just some flabby and perfunctory piece of surrealism. Kaufman is different. His films, this film in particular, really are genuinely dreamlike. Watching them is like being progressively enclosed in a disturbingly immersive, lucid dream. Watching it, you can experience a genuine sense of rising panic that you don't know why you're there and you don't know what your exit strategy is. Because most movies have a conventional narrative exit strategy. Charlie Kaufman doesn't offer you anything of the sort. It has the grammar and language of a dream. Even David Lynch isn't properly dreamlike the way this is. Perhaps Buñuel or maybe Kafka are closer comparisons. It's maybe not my favourite Charlie Kaufman because it's not quite as funny or as spectacular as his masterpiece Synecdoche in New York, but it's still a rather amazing piece of work. The other film I want to talk about is Mathias et Maxime by the Canadian director Xavier Dolan.
Est-ce que vous êtes déjà embrassé avant?
Hey boy.
Jamais fait dans la vaisselle, là, ce que? Parce que c'est ça, la scène que vous allez jouer dans le court-métrage d'Erika. Le gars qui se French.
Je l'avais-tu dit ou je l'avais pas dit qu'il y a une gosserie avec son esti de film blanc?
Là, t'as dit à moi que t'allais faire tes affaires de ton côté, fait que fais tes affaires de ton côté puis arrête de faire chier mes amis que t'es des marres.
C'est pas une idée de marre, là. C'est juste que ça arrêtait pas de nous dire.
Que ça fucking change, arrêtez pas de comme vous faire des tresses puis genre de wrestle comme les esti de wack.
C'est vrai qu'ils se sont fait de chance au secondaire 3?
Ouais, c'était classique.
Ouais, c'est quoi un classique tant que ça? Sinon, Matt, il l'aurait pas oublié.
Mais c'est clair que Matt, il criait pas sur l'autre de son char. J'ai frenché Max secondaire 3. Never forget.
Xavier Dolan is a filmmaker that I've come to like more and more and more as the years go by, and this new film is a love story, a coming-of-age story, a coming-of-30-somethinghood story. It's about two people who are experiencing all the painfulness of very young love or even teen love at a moment in their lives when they realize they have to make real decisions about where their careers and where their existences are gonna go. Max is played by Xavier Dolan, who is a very good actor, a character whose life has been put on hold for some years because he's had to look after his mother, a characteristically ferocious term from the Canadian actress Anne Duval. And his friend is Matthias, who is in a straight relationship with a woman, and that actor is Gabriel Dalmeida Freitas. Things become complicated when the two men are asked to appear in an amateur short film and have to kiss, which awakens long, dormant feelings in the pair of them. Dolan is very good at showing the excitement and the disturbance and the disruption that these new feelings cause in both men, and also the disturbance that they cause in the hive mind and the hive heart of their entire extended circle of friends. It's a very good film available now on streaming services. I review both these films in my column for The Guardian. Please buy The Guardian. And as for this vlog, thank you very much indeed for watching it. As ever, please give it a share, give it a like on social media, and of course, subscribe. Thank you.